4 years?
Oh, I don't know. It just feels like that. Well, for some of it has been, because some of these are graduating out and they've been with us for the entire 4 years. They've made their schedules work so they could be in band and in the jazz band at the same time. On that one, that was Autumn Leaves, in case you didn't know what the title was. And the soloist on that one was Chase Trump. And the saxophones, they begged me to stand up so they could show off. So I said, well, okay, I'll let you do that. The next piece we're going to be playing is, we're playing a lot of old songs just because we like them. And this one was first recorded by Duke Ellington. And the guy that wrote this was Johnny Mercer. Now, Johnny Mercer did a lot of lyrics for a lot of people, a lot of songs, and it's very coincidental that the first piece we played, Autumn Leaves, the lyrics were by Johnny Mercer. So, this is Satin Doll, and soloist on this one is going to be Miss Julia Avery over here on alto sax, and Mr. Danny Manier back over here on trombone. And if you want to applaud for them when they get through, you can. I mean, that's the nice part about jazz. We're a little bit more relaxed. Thank you. I guess it's all this change of weather that we keep having. It gets cool, it gets hot, it gets cool, it gets humid, it gets more humid, it gets humider. No, that's not right. Oh, okay. Next piece we're going to be playing is, it's by one of the really greats of music, not just jazz, but music. Stevie Wonder. He began in 1961 as Little Stevie Wonder, and he was 12 years old. And if you ever listen to a recording of it, and it's fingertips, he goes out there and it's just like, he's 12 years old. It's just amazing. And he had a really, he still has a really good career going on. Of course, let's see, 1960, he's in the 60s already, approaching 70. But we're gonna be doing one of the pieces from his Songs in the Key of Life, Sir Duke. Set back there is Mackenzie Horton. Mackenzie, stand up. He's trying. Does a really good job. In case you're wondering what these things out here, we actually went to two contests this year. It's the first time we've gone in a very long time to a contest. One was in Palo Alto and one was up at Bandera. And at Palo Alto, we were chosen as the outstanding band in our classification. And we were competing against, and there was nobody in our classification except for us, Southwest High School second and third jazz bands. So I was like, oh, okay, that was really nice. And Robert Rutherford was chosen as outstanding soloist over there. And then we went over to Bandera, and at Bandera, we did have competition. Honda was there, Bernie was there, Fredericksburg was there, Bandera was there, there were five of us, and they gave us a one, because we did so well, and they also chose us as the outstanding group in our classification, and at that contest, Chase Trout, he was chosen as outstanding singer. So, what you're seeing up here is a lot of work. We figured it out. It takes us about 1 week to put a piece together. Putting a piece together means we can play it from beginning to end in 1 week. In 2 weeks, we make it sound really good. By the third week, it's a performance level. And so, every piece you're seeing is basically 1 week. So, this is 10 charts we're playing tonight. So this was work with 10 weeks worth of work that you're hearing up here on the stage. And we don't play them for 10 weeks solid. Once we get it, we put it away, next chart, put it away, next chart. So you're seeing a lot of work from this group. And it really has paid off. They're a great group. Okay, we're gonna change styles now. We're gonna go ahead and play a little Elvis Presley, Can't Help Falling in Love. The problem is, this isn't Elvis Presley. This is UB40. Now, for those of you who know UB40, that means you grew up in the 90s. Because UB40 was a reggae group. So, we're going to be playing Can't Help Falling in Love, little reggae. And we have Victoria Huron and Samuel Garcia Rodriguez playing solos on this one. So, Can't Help Falling in Love.
Thank you.
be playing Body and Soul, and this one was written by, who did this? Okay, it's Body and Soul. Sorry, I thought I had that one written down, and I don't. So this is Body and Soul. It's actually a pretty old group, or a pretty old chart, in that it came out in 1930, and this has become a standard in jazz literature. The reason that we don't know exactly who's saying this is because so many different people, Louis Armstrong played it, I think Frank Sinatra did it. There's been so many versions of it, and it's just a really, really pretty piece. We kind of stumbled on this one. We needed a ballad, and so this one came into play. And on this one, we're going to have Selena Morley and Chase Trail playing solo. So this is Body and Soul. We had to have a ballad, and I looked at that one, and we started playing it, and Chase played it, and I thought, man, that'd be really nice on Barry Sax. So I just had Selena go ahead and play along with them, and it worked out really, really nice. An award. For the Outstanding, the Jazz Director's Award for Outstanding Freshman in the freshman category goes to our outstanding freshman, Mr. Robert Rutherford. Okay, we'll have some more, but not yet. Okay, Lieber Tango. Oh, we're gonna go south of the border now. Like I said, I like to play different styles, but this group, it's not, okay, we're just gonna play one style. No, no, no. They have to play. And sometimes it is a big challenge. Sometimes we actually have to work a lot. Libre Tango, this is in our library, and it's one of those pieces that they enjoy playing, and they constantly, can we play it? Can we play it? Can we play it? And so I always like to have at least 2 years before we repeat a song. And it's been about 2 years since we played Libre Tango. It's a tango. Argentina. If you've never been down there, I haven't either. But it's a really nice piece of music. Libre Tango. Job easier. I know I didn't say easy, I said easier. But every single one of them has had to overcome their own little problems. sax players who get nervous when they play their solos. Our trumpet players, you want me to play? Yes. There's nothing there. I know. You have to make it up. You mean without anything else? You got it. So it's really fun to see them as they progress and they develop, because when they first start out, they are so tentative about doing anything. And as they progress, they gain more and more confidence. So by the time they're getting to be seniors and juniors, it's just like, I want you to do this, okay. I want you to, okay. And they just do it. Sometimes they fight, I want to do it, which is a nice thing to have, nice problem. Okay, and a more, outstanding sophomore. Every student, like I said, up here has done a great job, but some have just done a little bit more, stood out. The Outstanding Award of Jazz Director's Award for Outstanding Sophomore goes to Mr. Samuel Garcia Rodriguez. Samuel also got a $1,000 scholarship for a little essay he wrote for school band and orchestra. It was a national program, and he wrote a really nice article. And he was chosen as one of 10 for the entire United States. So he does a great job of playing. Okay, so now, Come Fly With Me. If you don't know who did this, the guy's name was Frank Sinatra. If you don't know who Frank Sinatra is, you haven't listened to a lot of music, because he's done some really fine stuff. There was a little thing on TV where they said he has 3 stars on the Hollywood Walk, and one is for acting, one is for music, and I don't remember what the third one for, but he got 3 anyway. So here we go. This is Come Fly With Me, and there are no soloists. This is just the whole group playing, so it's a really pretty piece. Thank you. award goes to our outstanding junior. And it's really hard to pick. Now it's getting harder and harder because every single one of the juniors up here has done something really impressive. So I had to think quite a bit on this one. But I came down to the conclusion that the outstanding junior this year goes to Miss Julia Avery. One that I didn't pick. Chase picked this one. He said, how about we play that a kick in the head? And I was like, okay, fine. So I went and I looked for it. And the only one I could find was a vocal rendition of it. And well, none of us wanted to sing. So I had to modify it a little bit. So I took the vocal line and gave it to Selena and Chase. And this one was originally with Dean Martin, and he was one of the Rat Pack. And for those of you who are too young to understand, they're not from Ratatouille, okay? The Rat Pack was a group of singers in the late 50s, early 60s, and Dean Martin just happened to be one of them. So this is Ain't That a Kick in the Head. Long day for them, not me. They're like, oh, okay. All right, last award. The last award goes to our outstanding senior. And it is the Louis Armstrong Award, because if you know who Louis Armstrong was, he was the ambassador to the world. He came out, was just so influential for so many people, and he would travel abroad so much. And this person has exemplified all that. They've done just a fantastic job. I hate to see them go because they've been truly outstanding. When they go places, people go, "You're from Pleasanton, aren't you?" And they're going, "Yeah, I am." There, so she's made a name for herself. And she missed the All-State band by one chair. They only take one. She was number two, but to me, she's number one. Okay, our next piece, I usually don't take requests, but this one I asked because they're always at our concerts and they have nobody involved in the program. They just come because they like it. And he's retiring this year. So they told me, and I was like, ask Mr. Williamson what he wants us to play. And he came up with Sentimental Journey. So I went out, found it for him, and this is for him. Our soloists are going to be Bryce Benavides, Victoria Huran, and Mr. Chase Trail, Sentimental Journey.
Thank you.
unfortunate for me, for them, they're like, yes, finally. Singers are Rosie Gonzalez. Yeah, Rosie. Felix Gutierrez. Danny Veneer. Selena Morgan. Chase Trell. And on piano, Elaine Cummings. Thank our administrators. They've been very supportive. They allow us to go. Airport, we go to, well, any place they need us to play. And they always have lots of music. What you're hearing tonight is only part of what they have. There's another six or seven pieces that we have in the back that was just like, no, we're not playing this tonight. So it is, what you're hearing is not everything we've done for this semester. It's only a portion of it. And administration really helps us, allows us to do things. And the school board, of course, they do a lot for us too. So you're seeing a compilation of a lot of work up here. And well, for that small group, it is coming to an end. So our last piece for the number is just a fun piece. Just fun. Jumpin' Jack Jive.